Amen. Hallelujah. You know that the Conad is the hour they do it while you saw a young man, a woman that labor in Europe and buy machine and buy engine and put in the container and landed at Ladipo because he is ignorant of the market. All of you go and do meeting. And Christians are involved in that thing. You know, he just come from Belgium with a container load of engine. You know he's ignorant of your market. He even come to you because you are a Christian. He saw someone book in your hand. He said, hey, this one is my brother. Brother, come help me. Let me sell this market. Yet you will go and rohin with your friend and say, hey, we won't give out more than 30,000 for one engine. 30,000. You agree? 30,000, yes. They all of them scatter in the market. Then this one will come from north. How much? 30,000. The other one will come again from south. How much? 30,000. The other one will come again from east. How much? 30,000. The other one come from south. How much? 30,000. At the end of the day, she will lose and you become big man. Then when you get to village, your God will anoint your uncle to wait for you. Amen. Then he said, since last December, I come back from village. I don't know how my business is doing. Of course, how will you know? You don't know how you get the money. Somebody was crying and you were rejoicing. So your uncle had to stop your joy so you can begin to cry too. Church, God said, you are now where Satan is sitting down. You see? Because they gradually and shifted during the dark ages until the church get married to the world. And what was sown in Pergamon church age has graduated in Laodicean church age. It become a big tree with branches and fruit. Hallelujah. May God help us in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Not only the brothers, there are the young women here. They are not interested to marry. If you tell her, Carol, she saw this one, you never bring any man, he said, Dibakoko. He said, husband, let husband go to hell. What does he want to do with husband? Amen. Christmas is drawing closer now. You will increase the number of your boyfriends. So that as Christmas is approaching now, you will go and tell Namdi, I love you past my mother. Then he went to Susan, I went to John, I love you past my mother. Then you go to Hassan, I love you past my mother. You go to Enobo, I love you past my mother. So that you will go there and collect 20,000 for Christmas gift. You know, go buy me Christmas thing, 20,000 from Enobo. You know, buy me Christmas thing, 20,000 from John. You know, buy me Christmas thing, 20,000 from Suzanne. So at the end of the day, your pocket is full. Amen. If you go to a Kennedy Chukwu, they say if it's 10,000 naira for here to Abba, you say I will pay. After all, it's not your money. Then before 22, 20 take off, you're already in your village. Carrying big portmanteau from 419 from various men. And your old mother is worried. Why are you not marrying Anne? Mama, no man don't come yet. How would they come? They cannot come. Because you said you're not looking for one. You're already certified. Amen? Hallelujah. The church went and make her abode where Satan's throne is. It means the church become worldly and get married to the world economic and political system of things. So you see a Christian, you don't know whether he's a Christian or an unbeliever. A daughter of God, a son of God, turned at bus stop, side by side with blue back unbeliever, there is no difference. May God help us in Jesus' name. We are looking at Pergamum church age. Why God will be that church age? Amen. Hallelujah. You know, if you go to the book of Matthew chapter 4, verse 8, Satan boasted there. Praise the Lord. Again, the devil taketh him up into an exceeding high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and the glory of them, and said unto him, all these things will I give thee if thou wilt fall down and worship me. Amen. Hallelujah. If you fall down and worship me, go to the book of Luke. The more clear in the book of Luke. Amen. Praise the Lord. Verse 5. Luke chapter 4, verse 5. And the devil taking him up into a high mountain, show unto him all the kingdoms of the world in a moment of time. And the devil said unto him, all this power will I give thee, and the glory of them, for that is delivered unto me, and to whom I will, I give it. Amen. Beginning from Nebuchadnezzar Empire to Cyrus Empire to Alexander Empire to the days of Caesars. Amen. Can you read it now because of our time? On your own. Daniel chapter 7. Amen. From part 4. You notice that all those world empire, they are represented by one violent animal or the other. Telling you the spirit they were ruling on those empires. Amen. That devil was actually in control of them. Praise the Lord. To confirm what Satan was telling Christ here, that all this kingdom of the earth, they are under my control. It is whoever I pray that I give it to now. Amen. That is why you can hardly count 100 big man. Out of that 100, I can tell you maybe only 10. And their word is genuine. Amen. Only 10 that their word is genuine. In this church, I pray for money to come. Money refused to come. I say, I know why. There is millionaire and millions, but because of the type of thing pastor has said at this altar, they cannot bring their million. Because the million is not genuine. Because if that money enter the altar, the business will clog. The business will crash. The business will crash. That's why all the money that come to this church is from the people's labor and effort. Toro, kobo. If you want the big money, then throw the door open like Moluwe. Dog enter, pussy enter, cockroach enter. Money go food this altar. Amen. Hallelujah. So Satan is the one that influences the political and economic system of the world. Hallelujah. But the children of God, God will surely make a way where there is no way. Because he is the one that had the final say. Amen. He is the one in charge of the political system. And place some dictatorship in some countries. Like Idi Amin of Uganda. Amen. Like Abacha of our days. Hallelujah. Many of them. Like one man in Haiti, in Philippines. Dangerous human being on the throne. Amen. Like Pontius Pilate, who saw truth and was asking truth. What is truth? Ha! He was looking at truth face to face and was asking him what is truth. Did he answer him? Did he answer him? He didn't answer him. Amen. What was different within that man and the guy that were looking for eternal life and turned before eternal life and turned back and went back sorrowing? Glory be to God. It shall not be our portion. Praise the Lord. Amen. Now, I want him there. He said again, in the midst of what that church was passing through, in the midst they were suffering, in the midst of all the uncertainty and persecution, and their family member called them names, their father stopped paying their school fees, their uncle rejected them because they had declared for Christ. Hallelujah. They faced all manner of persecutions. In the midst of that persecution, if you look at the Pergamon church age, verse 13 still, it says, "Western dwell, and thou hold fast my name." They didn't give up to the name of Christ. Hallelujah. When their big sister had beginning to say, "Hey, Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Hey, Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Hey, Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you." These people see her up in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. You see? Because they had the revelation of his name. When they had started praying in the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Ghost, amen. This one was saying in Jesus' name. Because they had the revelation of the name of Jesus Christ. Jesus commended them. That you, among all the problems, you did not give out to my name. You see, hold fast to my name. Because in my name, all things are possible. In my name, the dead will raise. In my name, demons will fly away. In my name, all things become possible. In my name, closed door will open. In my name, the blind will see. In my name, the dead will hear. In my name, the lame will walk. Amen. They had the revelation of that name. It is not Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, but a name. It is a family name, brother. Hallelujah. That was why, if you had not gotten the revelation of that name, you will not know the difference between Father, Son, and Holy Ghost and Jesus' name. You will not know it. Because there are churches today that when they want to go and baptize believers, they instead of saying they are confused, I said they are confused. Because they are confused, they will go and baptize them in the name of the Father and Son and the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. will take somebody to water and say, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. So you don't want to make mistake. So let's use the two. Hallelujah. Can we say, Lord, thank you very much? Can we say it again? Can we say, Lord, thank you very much? Again, again, again. You know why? Because you are not in Babylon. You should thank God that you are not in Babylon. Because all that are in Babylon, they are confused. Amen. Praise the Almighty Father. The Bible says in the book of Colossians chapter 3 verse 17. Amen. We should do what? Whatever you want to do in word or in deed, do it how? Do it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So this church, having received that revelation from the very first beginning, they hold on to it, kakaraka. When others were saying, in the name of Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, they say, no, our own is in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. When they begin to baptize in the title of Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, we say, no, our baptism must be in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because it is the name that has been revealed to the elect of God. It is the name that has been revealed to the elect of God. The Bible says in the book of Philippians chapter 2, you know it, hallelujah, that Christ has received a name that is above, was given a name that is above every other name. That are mentioned of his name. What will happen? They had a revelation of my name. No matter what happened, you have hold fast to my name. Our three brides assembly have hold fast to that name. Come rain, come sunshine. We can't give up to that name. Because in that name is authority. In that name is dominion. In that name is the final seal to any matter. Because when that name is invoked, Satan trembles. Amen. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, and took a form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men, and being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death at the cross. Wherefore, 9. God also had highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow, or thing in heaven, or thing on earth, or thing under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is. Satan knows better. Satan knows more than some Christian. Amen. If he enter a court, temple, or chamber, you can see that there be shouting in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. And the demon will believe at you. In fact, the demon will be clapping hand and following you. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. The demon will be dancing with you. You are singing song. You are singing song to the demon. That demon will clap your hand and follow you. No matter the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. No matter the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. No matter the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. And the demon will follow you and clap your hand. Spiritual husband will be clapping hand and following you. Spiritual wife will be clapping hand and following you. But if you say, in the name of Jesus Christ, the spirit will take over. The spirit will take cover. Because that name comes with fire. That name come with thunder. It is the name of the Almighty God. Satan know. But Christian leaders didn't know. Because it's time. Church, it's time. God in his program opens a new chapter. Only two group of people knows about it. Ethan God in his move take a bend. Only two group of people knows about it. Satan and the elect of God at that hour. Satan will know it. Only the few elect will know about it. That God had taken a corner. God had taken a bend. Only Satan and few elect will know that. So you are privileged. Amen. That was that we are privileged people. That in our days, God opened a new chapter in his move and carry all of us into that new chapter to be part of it. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hebrews chapter 1 verse 4. He said by inheritance, he obtained more excellent name than the angels. Hallelujah. Amen. And the Lord had to confess in John chapter 5 verse 43. He said, whatever I am doing, I come in my Father's name. Letting you know that the name is bearing, it is the Father's name. Instead of God calling him Junior, he called him his real name. Amen. Instead of, listen to me, some of you don't know this thing. If you see a man born his first son and call him Junior, he's only telling him that is my junior. If that man's name is Isaac and he's calling his son Junior, he's only telling you that the boy's name is Isaac, the Junior. Did you hear me? If he called him Emmanuel Junior, he's only telling you that the father's name is Emmanuel. The other, his son is Emmanuel, the Junior. Amen. Hallelujah. If you go to part of Imo State in Abia State, in places like Bende or Hafia, Abriba, you will hear names like Imo, Imo, Carlo, Carlo. The father is Carlo. The son is Carlo. So the boy's name will be Carlo, Carlo. So don't think it is a nickname. It is not a nickname. So the name Jesus was the father's name that he got to only begotten son. And it was by merit, having satisfied all the requirements. Amen. Having been given a placement in God's family, God give him a name. We shall get there. Amen. It is not just that I'm born again. Many are called, but few are placed. I don't mean choosing. Many few are given a placement. That is adoption. Amen. For you to be adopted as a son, there is certain standard requirement that you must be fulfilled. It is an assessment. When the tutor completely assesses you, who have been bringing you up, he will assess you. He can recommend you to your father and tell your father, hey, oh God, this your son is your replica. This your son. If you are not there, he is there. You go to a point as a son, when you sign, it is good that your father has signed it. When you say it, you are saying your father's mind. When you conclude it, when your father comes, he will not add to anything to it. Because what you did was what is supposed to be done. That's what Jesus said, when you see me, you are saying my father. It's an adoption. We have to mature to that level to be adopted as sons into God's family. It's not a game. It's a serious business. Amen? Hallelujah. So you can be called and not given a placement because you don't meet when the chamberlain, were preparing you of all the things that the chamberlain deposited to make you appear before the king. All the effort of the chamberlain did not yield the required result. So he couldn't appear before the king. Amen? It wasn't only Esther that were prepared by those seven chamberlains. There were other maidens. Go back and read the book of Esther. There were other maidens that were chosen with alongside with Esther. Bible says his uncle Mordecai was praying and fasting for her. So that all the things that the chamberlain were putting inside her, preparing her, they were manifesting in Esther. And the chamberlain was satisfied when it was time for her to appear before the king. And when he appeared before the king, based on what the chamberlain had been put inside of her, when the king saw her, he didn't commend. He just issued her the scepter. An acknowledgement. So, let it not be they are preaching the wrong word of God. You that are eating the wrong word of God, I hope you are graduating to Jesus Christ in character, in behavior, in utterances, in nature. If not so, you will be part of the other maidens with Esther. But may you not be our portion in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. In John 17:6, still talking about this name, Jesus praying there in Gethsemane, he was telling the Father, he said, Father, I have manifested your name. Amen. So all the people shouting, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, you better study and show yourself approved. There is a name. That is what? In verse 6, Jesus was saying here, if you read from verse 5, oh, and now, oh Father, glorify me with thy own self, with the glory which I have with you before the world was. I have manifested thy name unto the men which thou givest me out of the world, thy they were, and thou givest them me, and they have kept thy word. There was a name they were revealed to Peter, James, and John. That was a name that the church in Pergamos, even though the remnant of them, they were still there now, they still hold on to that name, Kakaraka. Even when Roman Catholic had changed the name to Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, and Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord with you too. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord with you too, and Canting Chaplet. And the condition of people still remain the same. In the book of Judges chapter 13, verse 15 to 18, you can go and read that one. Amen. The angel, when Manoah said, hey, oh God, can we know your name? Remember, it was the angel of the Lord, not an angel of the Lord. It was the angel of the Lord. Amen. Showing that it was God in an angelic form. It was God characterizing that angel. Amen. He said, tell us your name. What you are saying now, when it comes to pass, when we will testify, we can say it was Mr. Labaja that came and gave us this message. His message had come to pass. Amen. The angel say, why are you asking my name? Can't you see that my name is secret? Amen. Remember, that angel that came at that time, he came in respect of the deliverance of Egypt, the deliverance of Israel, who was in bondage to the Midianite. So, as far as the plan of redemption and deliverance was concerned, as at that time, the name was still secret. Only to be revealed at the fullness of time. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. So we must hold on to that name. Amen. Hold on to that name. In the dream, when you are attacked, if you can just say, Jesus. Jesus, the demon with two flight. Don't mind the people. Instead of shouting Jesus, they will shout, God of choosing, God of choosing, God of choosing. The demon will give you a knock. And some of you had this emulative spirit. God of bride, God of bride. Stop it, though. There is a name that demon hears and tremble. There is a name demon hear and take over. There is a name demon hear and move away. If you like, go and shout, God of bride, God of bride, he go hold you for truth. The fourth item there. He said, and did not deny my faith. Ha! That church, under serious persecution, under serious worldly pressure, the world pressure was upon that church to change status and deny Jesus Christ. Pressure of the world, pressure of money, pressure of fashion, pressure of popularity, pressure to belong to the acceptable groups, pressure to be like my mate, pressure to be like my friends. It was upon them. The Bible says, but they did not deny my faith. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. They will not deny the faith. Look at the book of Matthew chapter 23. He said there was a three measure of me that a woman muddled up. And all of them were muddled up. When others were praying, penance, indulgence, and purgatory, this little group, they were holding on to justification, sanctification, and baptism of the Holy Ghost. No matter the pressure, amen. Because they have the revelation of truth. If you are here, you have revelation of truth. Say, thank you, Lord Jesus. You don't have it. If you have it, you will shout it more than that. If you have the revelation of truth, say, thank you, Lord Jesus. Again. 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 That means you know the value of the truth that you have. If you know the value of the truth that you have, it will be exciting you every time. Amen? It will make you very, very happy every time. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen? They hold on to the faith of Jesus Christ. They hold on to the revelation of Jesus Christ. Nothing moving out of it, because even us that are here now, listen to me. If you really believe, if you say you really believe, God will test you. Amen. If you say you really believe this message, prepare, God will test you. Amen. Because every true son or daughter that cometh must be tried. He must be tried. Hallelujah. So that when that hour come, whether you will abide, whether you will change city. Some are being tested with delayed marriage. Some are being tested with delayed marriage. And they are murmuring and complaining. You are still yet carnal. And God is preparing his son for you. And under the unfailing purpose of God, if he will give you his son now, both of you will disgrace him in your yard. So God is taking his time to equip you so that you can align with his son. And you think it is delay marriage. It is not delay marriage. It is the unfailing purpose of God that is in operation in your life. Amen. And those who don't understand and that God is trying them, because your trying period is your time of preparation for the purpose of God. Some of them had left Lagos and went to Abuja. See, the husband is not in Lagos. Let me go and look where it is in Abuja. And when they go to Abuja, because they are no longer in Lagos, they will change their address. And dressed like worldly young girls, so that the man will see their buttocks that is big, so that it can be attracted with your buttocks. I'm sorry for you. If the man is marrying you because of your big buttocks, be prepared for the law of diminishing return. Because it will set in. So they are going to, when they leave Lagos, they went outside another city. And they go and buy body hug, and then their breasts will protrude. I sorry for you. You don't know what is the Lord diminishing return. And listen, if you're a true daughter of God, and you are under God's divine purpose, which I call God's unfailing purpose, I have a message for that. If you're under that purpose, if you like, spend 6 years in Abuja, you will come back here. My, it is unfailing purpose of God. It's in Lagos, not in Abuja. The time you think it is delaying, God is preparing you for what he wants to give you. Because if he gives it to you now, you can't keep it. You never see people that marry yesterday and scatter next tomorrow. You didn't see it. You never see people that marry today and as soon as they enter the man's house, his condition got worse and she ran away out of the marriage. Say, me, I don't want to suffer. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You must be tested. Amen. Brother, you must be tested. If you have really believed this message, you must be tested. Certainty. So, stop running up and down and thinking time is going. Time is not going anything. What you're thinking is delay. When Baba finishes with you, when you enter that marriage, you will be first lady. You said you will know that you are first lady. Because God has prepared a cushion chair that you can sit down and relax. And when people come to your house, you'll be proud. You'll be proud to welcome your friend to your husband's house. You'll be real missus. Amen? Papa can call you up and say, hey, this sickness that is worrying me, They say it is operational and they are charging us 80,000. You mean to be running kuru 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 kuru? You just call your darling, you go pull up drone and bring up 80,000. Then that time you can be proud. Not to be running kuru 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 and sell your rapper and sell fridge and sell stereo. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So let us submit ourselves to the spanking of the Holy Spirit, so that when He finished dealing with us, we shall be what God wanted to be. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Therefore, let every other person here that is under the present stress, remember, don't stop changing city, stop changing job, stop dressing like the world, thinking it will work that way. It will never work that way. You are a daughter of God, you are a son of God. The purpose of God in your life will be fulfilled. Let's bow our head. I want to hang it here.